RobinReaction.com.
In this video, I'm going to go over how to find the empirical formula from mass, also called combustion analysis. And so our question reads, a 33.08 gram sample of an organic compound was combusted in oxygen and produced 80.73 gram carbon dioxide and 33.05 gram water. What is the empirical formula of the compound? All right, so we're going to find the answer to this by doing a series of steps. So step one is to find the mass of the carbon in the CO2 and the mass of the hydrogen in the H2O using percent composition. And so let's go ahead and break down this word problem into what we're actually trying to do. So when it says we have 33.08 grams of an organic compound, what that means is that it's going to contain carbon, hydrogen, and possibly oxygen. And I've put X, Y, and Z here because we don't know how many carbons, hydrogens, and oxygens we have. In fact, that's the whole purpose of this entire problem, is to figure that out. So those are our mystery numbers for right now. And then it says combusted in oxygen. So that means that it's going to be reacted with the O2 in the atmosphere. And then we are given the two products that were created after this reaction, which was carbon dioxide and water. All right, so let's go ahead and fill in all the masses that we know. So our mystery sample is 33.08, our carbon dioxide is 80.73, and our water is 33.05. So the next step is that we're going to find the mass of the carbon in the CO2 and the mass of the hydrogen in the H2O using percent composition. So conceptually, what you really want to understand for this is that we had this mystery compound. We basically set it on fire, we exploded it, we collected carbon dioxide and water. And so the key thing here is that any carbon that's in the carbon dioxide came from our mystery compound. Carbon can't just make itself up. It didn't come from the atmosphere. It didn't come from the O2. So when we say that we have 80.73 grams of carbon dioxide, 100% of the carbon that was in the mystery compound is now in the carbon dioxide. And that's the same thing for H2O. We didn't get hydrogen from the atmosphere or from the O2. The only place we can get hydrogen from is from that mystery compound. So if we figure out how much H we have in the H2O, we'll know how much H was in the mystery compound. That's the whole point of this problem, is we're going to kind of back solve. We're going to say we were given our final answer. Let's figure out how much we started with. Right now, we don't know if our empirical formula of our compound has oxygen in it. We weren't told, and we're going to have to figure it out by figuring out how much carbon we have, how much hydrogen we have, and then figuring out, does that add up to 33.08? So let's go ahead and figure out how much carbon and how much hydrogen we have by weight. We're going to do that with percent composition. So first we need the molar mass of our two known compounds. So the molar mass of carbon dioxide is 43.99 grams per mole. And the molar mass of water is 18.01 grams per mole. So now, doing percent composition, I'm going to take the mass of carbon, and we only have one for CO2, so that's going to be 12.01, divided by the molar mass of carbon dioxide. And so we get the amount of C that we had in CO2 was 27.30%. And so now doing the same thing, so percent composition for hydrogen is going to be 2.016, because we have two hydrogens, each one weighs 1.008, divided by the molar mass of water, 18.01. So the H that we have in H2O becomes 11.19%. All right, so now that we have the percent composition of any carbon sample in carbon dioxide, let's figure out exactly how much carbon we have in our CO2 sample. So we know that we were told that this sample created 80.73 grams of CO2. So what we need to do is figure out what's 27.3% of 80.73. And so we do that by just multiplying by the percent. So I do my percents by just multiplying the percent as a fraction with a denominator of 100. And so multiplying 27.3% by 80.73 grams, we got that there was a total of 22.04 grams carbon in our carbon dioxide sample. And so that means there's exactly 22.04 grams carbon in our mystery sample as well. Because remember, all the carbon that we got from CO2 came from our mystery sample. So now let's go ahead and do the same thing for hydrogen. So we were told that this water sample was 33.05 grams. So we go ahead and take that, multiply it by our percent, which I like to do as a fraction with denominator of 100. And so we get that we created 3.69 grams of hydrogen in this water, which means that our mystery sample had 3.69 grams hydrogen. So remember earlier I said we weren't really sure if our mystery sample had oxygen in it or not because we had to actually use oxygen in our reaction, so we don't know if the oxygen in CO2 and H2O came from either the O2 in the air or did it come from the O in our mystery molecule. And so for step two, we're going to go ahead and find the original mass and subtract carbon and H to see what is the mass of oxygen in this molecule. So remember, 33.08, that's our mystery sample overall, subtracting the amount of carbon that we know was in the mystery sample, and then subtracting the amount of hydrogen that we know was in the mystery sample, we get that there are 7.35 grams left. So this means that this must be oxygen, because we already know that we have carbon and hydrogen. The only other thing we could have is oxygen. And so the missing 7.35 grams from our original 33.08 gram sample must belong to oxygen. All right, so step three, divide the mass of each known molecule by its molar mass to get the number of moles in each element. So once again, we're going to use how many grams we have, and now we're going to start figuring out, well, how many moles does that add up to? All right, so our three known molecules are one, CO2, two, H2O, and now we also just have the extra oxygen that we found in step two. So let's go ahead and we're going to divide the mass of our known molecule by its molar mass, and that will give us the number of moles of each element. All right, so for these, we're using 80.73 because that's the number of grams of carbon dioxide we made. We're using 33.05 grams for water because that's the amount of water that we made. And now for oxygen, we're just going to use the molar mass of a single oxygen atom. So we know from step number two, we created 7.35 grams of oxygen. All right, so these are the numbers we get. And then one more little addition. We have two hydrogens in H2O. So to get the number of moles, we're going to have to multiply our hydrogen number by two. All right, so now we have how many moles of each of our elements right here. All right, so step four, divide each number of moles by the lowest amount of moles. This is your mole ratio, and your empirical formula is found directly through ratios. Because remember, the empirical formula only tells me the ratio of the different elements involved in the molecule. It does not tell me the number of different elements involved in the molecule. That's what the molecular formula does. So we're just looking for a ratio. Sometimes the empirical and molecular formula are the same, sometimes they're not. All right, so what we mean by this rule is the lowest number, so that is this guy. We're going to take our other numbers and divide by that. And that's because we know in a molecule, every single molecule is going to have at least one of each atom that it has, right? And we know since there was extra mass that this molecule definitely has oxygen. And so we know that there's going to be at least one oxygen atom. And so that's kind of our ratio for the number one. So let's go ahead and divide. All right, and let's calculate all of our mole numbers. And so you're often going to get kind of scraggly numbers like this, and you can go ahead and just round them to their nearest whole number. So 3.992 is pretty much 4, and 7.985 is pretty much 8, and then 1 is going to be 1. So these are our answers. We just figured out by dividing by the number of moles that our empirical formula has 4 carbons, 8 hydrogens, and 1 oxygen. All right, so a couple things here as we wrap up. One, remember this is not the molecular formula. This is just the ratio. So possibly our molecular formula could be C8H16O2. That's totally fine. But this is the lowest whole number ratio of the elements in this mystery compound. And then second, if this was confusing, that's totally normal. This is a very complicated problem. The main thing to kind of keep in mind as you study more and repeat until you understand these types of problems is that way back to step number one, it's all about knowing that, okay, yes, we made 80.73 grams carbon dioxide. What that really means is that all the carbon in that carbon dioxide came from our mystery molecule. So if we can figure out how much carbon came from that carbon dioxide pile, we know exactly how much was in our mystery molecule. And the same thing goes for hydrogen. And then all we did after that was we said, okay, we know how much was our total, we know how much carbon, and we know how much hydrogen. So unless carbon and hydrogen added up to the complete mass, we know whatever leftover mass has to be oxygen. Once we have our 3 masses, we can go ahead and find our number of moles of each different element, and then we use our number of moles to get a mole ratio. All right, good luck with these problems and happy studying.
Hey, I hope you liked that video. Please feel free to like, comment, or subscribe. And if you go to my website, I have a ton of free practice problems you can check out. And if you need even more help, you can hire me for one-on-one private tutoring sessions that are online. All right, thanks. That's it. Happy studying.